Good morning, students. Today we are going to see problem number 6 of exercise 7.1. Okay. See, consider the matrix A alpha is equal to cos alpha minus sin alpha, sin alpha cos alpha. Here, see A matrix with the suffix angle alpha, which means the elements in the matrix has an angle of alpha. Okay. So we have to show that A alpha, A beta equal to A of alpha plus beta. So you have to prove this. For that, what I'm going to do is first I'm going to find the value of A beta, and we have to multiply A alpha and A beta to find the left hand side. Okay. So first we'll write A alpha. My A alpha is, which is given in the question, that is cos alpha minus sin alpha, sin alpha cos alpha, right? And A beta, this is nothing but I'm just going to change my angle alpha into beta. So here my matrix will become as cos beta minus sin beta, sin beta and cos beta. Now we are going to find A alpha into A beta. This is nothing but an ordinary matrix multiplication of A alpha and A beta. Okay. So here I am going to write the matrix A alpha, that is cos alpha minus sin alpha, sin alpha cos alpha into cos beta minus sin beta, and here again sin beta into cos beta. So we are just going to multiply these two matrices. It's just an ordinary matrix multiplication. That is, we are going to multiply this row with this first column and the next column. Okay, first we are going to take the first column, first row, that is cos alpha minus sin alpha, and we are going to multiply this row with this column. So we'll be getting cos alpha into cos beta minus of sin alpha into sin beta. And next, again, first row with second column, that is minus of sin beta into cos alpha, again minus of, is minus of sin alpha into cos beta, sin alpha into cos beta. Next, we are going to multiply for second row with first column. So I have sin alpha cos beta. Okay, sin alpha into cos beta. Next, again cos alpha into sin beta. I have plus, that is cos alpha into sin beta. Next, again second row with second column, that is minus of sin alpha sin beta. And next is what? Minus of, okay, plus of cos alpha cos beta. Plus of cos alpha cos beta. So here this is nothing but, and see, you are new to this formula, right? But you learn this type of formulas in trigonometry, and we call these formulas as a compound angles. Okay, that is cos of A plus B. You have formulas like this in trigonometry. When you are learning trigonometry, you will be familiar with this formula. So cos of A plus B is nothing but cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. And similarly, you have formulas for cos of A minus B, cos of A minus B, for sin of A plus B. Sin of A plus B is nothing but sin A cos B plus of cos A sin B. Okay? Right? And you have formula for sin of A minus B also. So you will use this compound angles formula for replacing those values in this matrix. Okay? So first I have cos alpha cos beta minus of sin alpha sin beta, which is nothing but cos of A plus B. Here we have alpha instead of A and beta instead of B. Okay, so I am just going to replace my A and B with alpha and beta. So I can write cos alpha cos beta minus sin alpha sin beta in terms of cos of A plus B. Okay, and similarly here S of sine A cos B. Okay, so these are the formulas which I am going to use here. So I can write this as cos of alpha plus beta, and here this is minus of sine of alpha plus beta, and here this is sine of alpha plus beta, and this is cos of alpha plus beta. See, I have cos term in second place and sine term in first place. When we rearrange, we'll be getting cos alpha cos beta minus sine alpha sine beta, which is nothing but the formula of a compound angle, right? So I have got this, and let us mark this as equation 1. And now we are just going to find the value of A of alpha plus beta. Here, what we are going to do is, I'm just going to replace this alpha by alpha plus beta. Okay? So what is my first value of the matrix? Here I have cos alpha. If I replace that by alpha plus beta, I'll be getting cos of alpha plus beta. And here, minus, we are just replacing alpha as alpha plus beta because they have given you A of alpha plus beta. So this will again become alpha plus beta. And next is, again, sine of alpha plus beta. And this is cos of alpha plus beta. Okay, this is equation 2. So from 1 and 2, we can conclude what? Alpha, A of alpha plus beta is equal to A alpha into A beta. So this is my A alpha into A beta, right? So this is my first proof. And next, again we have another proof for this question. That is, find all possible real values of alpha satisfying the condition A alpha plus A alpha transpose is equal to what? See, they have given you a condition. What? A alpha plus A alpha transpose is equal to what? Using this condition, you are just going to find the value of the alpha. That is this alpha. Okay? You are going to find all sorts of real values that alpha can take you. Okay? So we will go for the solution now. That is, my condition is A alpha plus A alpha transpose is equal to 1. Right? What is my A alpha? A alpha is nothing but cos alpha minus sine alpha cos alpha. Sorry, alpha plus of. I'm going to take the transpose of A alpha. While taking transpose, I'll be getting cos alpha minus sine alpha. Transpose is nothing but changing of rows into column, right? Which is equal to I. Here, my I is of 2 cross 2 because my A alpha is 2 cross 2, that is 2 by 2 matrix. A alpha transpose is also 2 by 2 matrix. So the I which I'm going to take must be also a 2 cross 2, that is 2 by 2 matrix. See, this is an ordinary addition. We are just going to add. So if we add, I'll be getting 2 times of cos alpha. And here I have minus and here I have plus. So this will become 0. Again, here also I have plus and here it is of negative. I'll be getting 0. So cos plus cos is nothing but 2 cos alpha, which is equal to 1 0 0 1. See, these two matrix are equal, so I can equate the corresponding terms. So here they both are in 0. See, the diagonal, left diagonal is 0. So we can take off right diagonal, both are cos alpha, 2 cos alpha, here also I have 2 cos alpha. So I can equate 2 cos alpha equal to 1. So which implies cos alpha is equal to 1 by 2. So you just come for the table which you have learnt in 10th standard. What is, when the value of cos will be equal to 1 by 2. At what angle the value of cos will be equal to 1 by 2? It is nothing but cos of pi by 3. When that is, pi by 3 is nothing but 60 degree. At 60 degree, the value of cos is equal to 1 by 2. And now I am going to write that 60 degree in radian, which is nothing but pi by 3. Okay? sorry, cos 5 by 3. And again, this is another concept of trigonometric solutions. See, here we are mostly using trigonometry, so you'll be able to understand it easily when we go for trigonometry. Okay? Here, this is of the form of cos alpha is equal to cos theta, which we will learn in trigonometric solution. And the solution is the general solution of this equation. And this is the trigonometric equation. And this equation has this general solution. It's nothing but here alpha is equal to 2n pi plus or minus of theta. Okay? So I'll take this as theta. Here I have alpha, this is theta. The general solution, okay? The general solution of this equation is nothing but alpha is equal to 2n pi plus or minus theta, where theta is nothing but 5 by 3. So I can give my alpha as alpha is equal to 2n pi plus or minus 5 by 3. Okay? So it means for all sort of pi by 3, cos of pi by 3, I'll relatively get a value of 1 by 2, maybe of a negative or positive. See, if I have pi by 3 is nothing but 60 degree. If it lies in first quadrant, the value will be positive, right? Okay. The value will be positive. And if it goes for second quadrant, the value will be negative. Again, if it comes for third quadrant, again it will be negative. When it goes for fourth quadrant, again it will be positive. You will learn this all sort of things in trigonometry, and while you go for trigonometry, you will understand this concept very easily. Okay? For that, you just know the formulas alone. It is enough to know the formulas alone, and while going for trigonometry,